Polaventris presents Commodore 64 game called Grand Prix Circuit. This game was requested by Classic Game Discovery.
This is Grand Prix Circuit on Commodore 64, a game requested by Classic Game Discovery. It's probably the best Formula 1 racing simulator on Commodore 64, and I did play this a lot back in the day. So I would track this awesome music. Select the track. Go with, wasn't that Imola or something? Choose your car. I think you have three cars: Ferrari, Williams, and McLaren. Go with the Ferrari. Event load times are pretty decent in this game, considering it loads from a floppy. Yay. That was pretty cool animation back in the day. A bit like a test drive game. And here we go. Remember, this is just a practice. Good manual of gears, if I remember right. Come on. Oh. No, it's automatic. Got the same steering style as in test drive, except this one works. I think there is an option for manual gears too. Except if you're driving with a manual gears, it's really easy to blow up your engine if you rev it to the red limit and don't change the gear. Your car will explode. Have to say the frame rate is excellent for a less than a 1 MHz 8-bit computer. All 3D and all that. And it doesn't really get that much worse with the... Well, of course, the frame rate suffers a little bit from the racing when you got other cars, but still pretty impressive considering the hardware. I think I played this quite a lot until I got my Amiga 500 and so on. 3D Formula racing game there that I played a lot. Can't remember the name, but I think Benway has done a video about it. Excellent controls. Pretty cool sounds too. There's one lap. How do I exit the practice? That's just the sounds. Let's pause. I don't know. Oh, there you go. Did not finish. And that was the arrow left key. So let's try single race. Beginner difficulty, that's good enough for me. Go with... Here we go with Monaco. It's a difficult track. That's okay. It's not like I'm going to be good in the game anyway. Choose Williams or Accolade this time. I don't think there is so much of a difference though. And before the race, you got the qualifying round. Yeah, it must be the difficulty setting that sets the manual or automatic gears. Yeah, you don't have much buildings and the background seems almost identical to the last one. But still, at least the shape is right. And back in the day, this was good enough. Okay, even has the tunnel. With a terrible frame rate. But tunnel nevertheless. It's quite amazing how well it controls. Always thought the test drive driving style was really clunky and slow, but it works with this one. Push forward to accelerate, push back to brake. If you had them all the manual gears, you would use the fire button with the combination of forward or backwards to change the gear. Fourth, that's not too bad. Okay, straight into the game. You can see the other... Straight to the race. You can see the other cars. They are not, of course, not 3D, just scaled sprites. Yeah, works pretty well. There was a little bit of slowdown with the other cars around, but it's not that bad. Still playable. The damage meter is the empty bar to the right of the speed meter. That fills up when you crash and burn. And yes, you can lose the game by breaking your car. You can also spin out, which is pretty cool new addition to a Formula One simulator of this age. But as this is the easiest setting, looks like I'm doing really well. For the hairpin. Yeah, compared to the modern games, of course it's not very impressive in any way, but the late 80s this was awesome. And it still plays well. Maybe that's just my nostalgia value addition to the game. But still, the frame rate is decent. AI doesn't seem to be much of a challenge on the easiest setting. And the engine sound gets a little bit on your nerves. I think if you know the track, you can imagine the scenery. But the overall track shape is correct, just don't have any other landmarks other than the tunnel. Last lap. Looks like I'm also catching up a few of the last cars. Hopefully I don't crash into them. Would be a terrible way to lose a game. There seems to be a pit stop, I just can't remember if... Oh, after you can see some damage. If you had to do pit stops during the longer races. Out of my way. Just a few more turns. There you go. So there you go. Victory! Not something you see often on my gameplay videos. Champagne, remember. Great tune. So there you go, that's Grabby Circuit in Commodore 64. Thanks for the request, and thanks for watching. We'll be right back.